Okay, the grid lines up. This is going to be the 22-lap race. Round three of the MotoGP World Championship. Loris Caparossi leads that championship from Nicky Hayden. But we have a new man in pole position. Chris Vermeulen, the 23-year-old Australian riding the Rizla Suzuki. It's only his third appearance on the machine, only his fifth appearance in MotoGP. He made his MotoGP appearance, in fact, here last year, riding for the Honda team, but he's put the bike on pole. Truly staggering performance by Vermeulen, who finished runner-up in the World Superbike Championship last year. Cool as a cucumber. There we go, that qualification time, 204.617. That was in the wet. 23 years old, one pole, and that, of course, is here in Turkey.
And I may as well start doing my rounds at the moment, Nick, and your namesake I've got beside me at the moment, Nicky Hayden. I bet you were smiling when you woke up this morning and saw that there was no rain and the clouds were clearing.
Yeah, it's all good. I mean, I ain't got no control on that weather, so... But this is good. I like it.
But you've been pretty consistent in the wet and the dry, so that must be a confidence booster to you.
Yeah, I feel good. Team's doing me a great job. These guys are working really hard, and, you know, we're trying to have fun right now. And, you know, when you're up front battling for wins and poles is fun, so we just got to keep it up and keep rolling, keep smiling, and try to stay up front.
I'm jealous because you have the best fun in the world.
Yeah, it's not a bad life, that's for sure.
Good luck, mate.
Thanks.
Nicky Hayden.
Yeah, Nicky Hayden qualified second fastest. It's his 50th MotoGP appearance, and he's chasing his seventh consecutive podium finish. And as I told you, he lies second in the World Championship, just 5 points behind the championship leader, Loris Caparossi.
Try and get a word with Loris Caparossi as he talks to his team.
Loris, I'll just tell you, has qualified fourth fastest on the second row of the grid, his first appearance at the Istanbul Park Circuit.
Loris, probably not where you want to be on fourth position, but it's better than being further back, but proving that the Bridgestones are getting better and better.
Yeah, well, you know, this season is coming really good for us, you know. This fourth position is not too bad because for me this is the first time in this track, but the Bridgestone working really hard and we hope to make it a good job today.
First time on the track, what were your impressions?
Yeah, not so easy track, you know. We take one day good and one day which rain. I need a little bit more time to learn. I learn today, no problem.
I bet you'll learn pretty quick.
Yeah, I hope so.
Good luck.
Thank you.
That was Loris Caparossi, fourth position on the Ducati with the Bridgestone tyres on it.
And his 50th MotoGP appearance for Loris Caparossi. His teammate, Sete Gibernau, has qualified third fastest and only his third appearance for the Ducati team. And Sete Gibernau, in fact, started the race here last year in pole position. But his last podium finish was Germany 2005. Sete Gibernau really settling into Ducati and settling into the new team. And one would imagine he's looking for another podium finish here. We're on the second row now. We've just spoken to Loris Caparossi. He's done well to qualify fourth fastest because, as he said, he didn't get an extra day, did he? Because it rained all day on Saturday. So not so easy for Loris Caparossi. But they were very impressive in the rain, Loris Caparossi and Sete Gibernau. But I'm happy to tell you it's dry for the race this afternoon.
On second row of the grid, I've got John Hopkins. It's all the waiting's over now, John.
Yep, time to go play, time to have some fun. I think we can get a really good start and hang with the leaders. I mean, that's the plan.
Well, the Suzuki's been starting to show its potential after what happened in Qatar. That's a long memory now.
Yep, long memory. It's time to go forward and try and get our best result.
All right, and again, all the best.
Cheers, thank you.
John Hopkins, a likeable American. They're always likeable, the Americans. They've always got a smile on their face.
Yeah, John Hopkins has done very well indeed to qualify fifth fastest. He's on that second row of the grid. Good start will be absolutely crucial, obviously, for Hopkins and his teammate, Chris Vermeulen. But Vermeulen in pole position. And after the problems they had in Qatar and the well-publicised pictures of John Hopkins taking his frustration out on the bike, very, very good to see Suzuki right back in the frame, chasing that first ever Grand Prix victory since 2001, Valencia. Sete Gibernau on the old 500cc two-stroke. And then their first pole secured from 2004, Kenny Roberts in Rio.
Well, I've moved down the back of the grid a bit now. I've got Casey Stoner in seventh position. Casey, not where you want to be, but with what happened during qualifying, I suppose it's not too bad.
No, we can't really complain. You know, we're second Michelin, and you know, the wet conditions were pretty hard yesterday and we just didn't manage to find a good enough setup for the end. But no, I'm reasonably happy with this qualifying position and, you know, we had a pretty good setup in the dry this morning and on Friday, so we'll just have to see how it goes.
Yeah, well, you were probably basically leading the sheets for most of it on Friday and then again this morning you're well up there, so that's a good confidence boost too.
No, definitely, and, you know, we're just going to have to see who's got a decent race set up and I think it's a bit of a gamble, you know, going into this race because nobody's had a lot of time to, you know, set up for the end of the race.
Well, you did well in Qatar, mate. Hopefully you can, now that you're over the illness of the flu, you can kick off from where you left off.
Hopefully, we'll see how we go.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Casey Stoner qualified seventh fastest on that third row of the grid. We just had a look at Randy Depruniere, his best ever qualifying in MotoGP, riding the Kawasaki. As we told you earlier, the first time he has out-qualified his teammate, Randy Depruniere. Just to remind you, if Casey Stoner did win this race, he would be exactly the same age as Freddie Spencer, 20 years, 196 days, when Freddie Spencer became the youngest ever rider to win a Premier Class race in Belgium in 1982. Oh, all seems like a long, long time ago. Casey Stoner having just a little look at the weather, I can tell, and you can probably reiterate this, Mark. The weather's probably better than it's been for about 1.5 days now.
It's almost perfect. A bit too cold to be called perfect conditions for racing, but you'll have to forgive me. I've gone from one Australian to the other and leading the field at the front of the grid. Congratulations again, Chris, and it must be a really good feeling to be here.
Yeah, without a doubt. You know, the team worked very, very hard all weekend, and the track was very different yesterday, completely wet. We had a good qualifying session and my first pole in MotoGP, but the track's bone dry now. We didn't get a lot of time in the dry here. Friday was dry and Saturday was all wet. So it's a little bit of a stab in the dark with what we're going to do with tyres and things. But hopefully we can run at the front.
Well, how did warm-up go? Did you find anything that could settle on something?
Yeah, we tried a few different tyres in warm-up. I was in and out a lot. And I think I've changed the front tyre and hopefully I've gone the right direction. But we'll wait and see.
Well, I'm sure I'm saying on behalf of everyone at home, best of luck and go out there and kick some.
Yeah, thanks very much, Braxy.
No worries, mate. No, that was Chris Vermeulen on pole, making it two Australians, which I'm proud to say, in two Grand Prix. So we're in for one really fantastic race if the 125cc's and 250cc's have got anything to do with it.
It's only taken him about 5 minutes, hasn't he, into the MotoGP broadcast to remind us that Australians last time in Qatar and this time in Turkey. But congratulations to Chris Vermeulen. That was a truly staggering performance and rode quite brilliantly in the conditions. Take advantage of the conditions. That's what you got to do. We come onto the third row of the grid. We've had a look at Shinya Nakano and Casey Stoner. Ninth fastest is Colin Edwards, as we told you. Colin Edwards had a nasty looking accident yesterday morning. Bashed up his shoulder, landed on his head, but he's a Texan, he's tough, he's the former World Superbike champion, and he's out-qualified his teammate Valentino Rossi for only the second time since they've been together at Yamaha.
And just a quick update on the track condition now. It's this sun's starting to, well, not sun, but the conditions are making sure it's warming up a bit now. Track temperature of just around 30 degrees and the air temperature almost a heat wave at 16 degrees.
Coming onto that fourth row, Kenny Roberts Jr., riding his father's KR211V Honda-powered machine, improving all the time. Good to see Kenny riding for his dad, and also just good to see Kenny Roberts, who's put so much into Grand Prix racing, both as a rider and a team manager, getting some success at last. And there they are, father and son together. Warren Willing, the man who's worked for Kenny Roberts for so long, just standing behind him. So, just 22 laps of this Grand Prix of Turkey, the Istanbul Park Circuit, 3 minutes to go before the start of the race. The MotoGP will be underway.
Just to even it up a bit, I've got Colin Edwards nowhere near where you want to be, but at least you're in front of your teammate.
Yeah, I can see where I want to be. It's just right up there. So, we made a change to the bike this morning after warm-up, and we're pretty confident that it's the right way. I mean, we've been struggling a bit, you know, as everybody knows. So, we'll find something.
Have a good massage this morning after what happened yesterday?
No, just took a hot shower this morning and got it loosened up, but yeah, feeling okay.
We'll get this thing loosened up and go to the front, mate.
You got it, thanks.
No worries, Colin Edwards always smiling again. Like I said, the Americans, no matter what happens, they seem to have a smile on their face.
Just had a look at his teammate, Valentino Rossi. Rossi down in 11th place, starts on the fourth row of the grid, but never discount the doctor. Further down, we find Tony Elias, 12th fastest alongside Valentino Rossi. Tony Elias, this is his 100th Grand Prix appearance. Of course, in the 125, 250, and very much so in MotoGP this season and a little bit last season.
I've got Jeremy Burgess, so I've got to be quick, Jeremy. Not what you wanted to do with qualifying with the wet and dry, but how was warm-up for you? Found something?
Oh, we'll see how we go. It's not good to be starting back here, but it's going to be dry. I think we've improved the bike some, so overall we might not move forward all the way to the front, but I'm just hoping we can move forward.
All right, mate, I'll leave you to it. I know you're busy.
Thanks.
There are Jeremy Burgess, the man behind Valentino Rossi. The team always work hard behind him. They work even harder when the chips are down. And you've got to say the chips are down at the moment for Valentino Rossi and that Yamaha team. Well, 5 minutes to go before the start of the race.
Well, that seems a lot that JB's saying that they don't expect to be up the front, but I think that's a bit of a double-edged sword there. He's telling just a bit of a defeatist attitude, but you know what they're like. They say what you don't want to hear, and just in case the results don't go their way. But I'm sure that Valentino Rossi will be up there very quickly at the start of the race.
Coming further down the field, Marco Melandri, the man who won his first ever MotoGP race here last year. He's only qualified 14th fastest. He starts from the fifth row of the grid. But remember, this was all in the wet yesterday. In the dry, it could be very, very different indeed. Two wins, one here in Turkey, the second one just 2 weeks later at the final Grand Prix of the season. That final Grand Prix of the season, of course, in Valencia. And I think that was Jorge Lorenzo, was it? Just giving him a good luck. Hurry up. So further down, Makoto Tomada, still struggling, Makoto Tomada. That switch from Bridgestone to Michelin tyres really hasn't suited the Japanese rider. He's qualified 13th fastest on that Konica Minolta Honda, and he starts from the fifth row of the grid alongside Marco Melandri and Carlos Checa. Danny Pedrosa, after all the excitement of the opening two rounds for the 250cc world champion, came down to earth literally in the rain yesterday, crashed in the Saturday morning practice session, and he's only qualified in the afternoon 16th fastest. And Pedrosa starting from the sixth row of the grid. But I bet, like many of the riders out there, he's so, so happy that the rain has stayed away. So, front row of the grid for round three of the MotoGP World Championship. Sete Gibernau, Nicky Hayden, and the big surprise, it's the 23-year-old Australian, Chris Vermeulen. Laps. We talk a lot about this circuit, but it is a super circuit. 5.340 kilometres, 3.318 miles. That's that front row. Chris Vermeulen, Nicky Hayden and Sete Gibernau. Row two, the championship leader, Loris Caparossi, John Hopkins and the impressive Randy Depunier. Row three, Casey Stoner started from pole 3 weeks ago in Qatar, Shinya Nakano and Colin Edwards. Row four, Kenny Roberts Jr., Valentino Rossi, the world champion, and Tony Elias. It's Valentino Rossi's 160th Grand Prix appearance. Row five, Makoto Tomada, Marco Melandri, the winner of the race last year, and Carlos Checa on that Tech 3 Yamaha. Row six, the 250cc world champion, Danny Pedrosa, Alex Hoffman, and Cardoso. And row seven, all on his own, British rider James Ellison. The riders now out on their final sighting lap. This may be your first glimpse of the Istanbul Park circuit. And conditions, Mark, as you told us earlier, not perfect, but very much better than we've seen previously this weekend.
Yeah, it's probably the best conditions we've seen all day. The temperature's rising, the track's got a bit of heat into it, get those tyres up to speed. And this magnificent circuit, one of the best layouts in the world, whether you're on four wheels or two wheels, it's got off camber, it's got on camber, it's got uphill, it's got downhill, it's got the fastest corner in GP racing, the longest corner in GP racing. It's just one magnificent complex, and hopefully we're in for some sensational racing. The hairs on the back of my neck stand here at the start of the race as these guys, these booming 990cc bikes, all on full throttle on the limiter as they take off.
Yeah, they're up at turn seven at the moment. We're on board with Valentino Rossi. Big race for Valentino Rossi because he's losing his way at the front of the championship at the moment, but just never discount him. Yamaha are obviously having their problems with the 2006 machine, but Rossi will never, never give up. He wants the challenge. He wants to be pushed to the limit, and he certainly is at the moment. As is this young man, Dani Pedrosa, the 250cc world champion, involved in a fabulous 250cc scrap here last year with Casey Stoner. In fact, Casey Stoner beat him just after a week late, just a week after Pedrosa had beaten him in Australia to win the world championship. Of course, Casey Stoner crashing out in that race. Make their way back down under the bridge. They break into the complex through the left and right. First it's left and then it's right. And then it's a final left that brings them back into the start and finish straight. And I can tell you already, we've seen races won or lost here today. We've seen races in the past won or lost here. The red flag being shown. The gladiators arrive for round three of the MotoGP World Championship. We're in Turkey. We're at the Istanbul Park Circuit. And we have an incredible front row of Chris Vermeulen, Nicky Hayden and Sete Gibernau.
All important for Vermeulen to get this Suzuki off the line quick and get and stick with him and see what happens from there, because I'm sure the Hayden's the one that's going to have the bullet in his helmet and try and get there and make them lead, follow him.
Chris Vermeulen, for the very first time in his career, starts a MotoGP race in pole position. Alongside him, Nicky Hayden and Sete Gibernau. The red flag has disappeared. The Grand Prix of Turkey is about to get underway. The lights change, and it's a good start by Vermeulen. Vermeulen makes a great start down the outside. Can he hang in there to get into turn one first? He can. Sete Gibernau in second place. It looks like Nicky Hayden third and John Hopkins fourth.
And Pedrosa coming well through from the rear as well, but Vermeulen getting that Suzuki off the line in sensational fashion. The lead up through this turn two, now into turn three, the little chicane, and backs it in already. Tyres a bit cold.
Chris Vermeulen leads the way up through turn two, up towards turn three, through the left and right. He got the start he wanted from pole position. Nicky Hayden right behind him. Looks like John Hopkins has now moved into third place. No, Sete Gibernau, sorry. John Hopkins third, Sete Gibernau second, Nicky Hayden in fourth place. And Sete Gibernau trundling Chris Vermeulen, and Sete Gibernau takes the lead. Sete Gibernau takes the lead up at turn seven. Gibernau leads the race on the Ducati. Vermeulen pushed a little bit wide. John Hopkins still in third place. Nicky Hayden in fourth spot. Casey Stoner also going well, just tucked in there behind Nicky Hayden. So Casey Stoner will be in fifth place. Loris Caparossi and Valentino Rossi has also made a pretty good start. But Vermeulen has made the start he wanted, but he's now been relegated to second place. Thinks about going up the inside there of Sete Gibernau, not able to do so. Through the left and right, the pack stream through. It's Colin Edwards up in eighth place, Randy Depunier ninth, and Loris Caparossi, the championship leader, in 10th place. Valentino Rossi now moving up into 10th place. Meccano 11, Elias in 12th. Through the 150, 160 mile an hour right-hander, down towards the complex for the first time, on the brakes. And it's Vermeulen that leads the way just from Gibernau. Hopkins trying to go up the inside there of Sete Gibernau. So Vermeulen back in front. Nicky Hayden in 4th place. Casey Stoner 5th. Into the left they come. Into the start and finish straight for the very first time. And Vermeulen starts the race in pole position. He should cross the line after lap one in pole position. Gibernau, though, alongside him. The extra power of the Ducati takes him past. And John Hopkins now going up the inside of Vermeulen. Does he run it a little bit wide? No. So Hopkins now up into second place. Hayden is in fourth place. Stoner fifth. Melandri, Caparossi, Edwards, Rossi now in ninth spot. Sete Gibernau leads the way. John Hopkins second. Chris Vermeulen third. Vermeulen now coming under pressure from Nicky Hayden.
And a sight for sore eyes to see the Suzuki's up there near the front after so long they've been struggling. But it's looking like Stoner and Hayden will be putting the pressure on very shortly.
Hopkins hanging onto the rear wheel there of Sete Gibernau's Ducati. Gibernau, the last man to bring success to the Suzuki way back in 2001. Sorting itself out there. And it's Casey Stoner now has got up in front of Nicky Hayden. So Stoner got past in front of Nicky Hayden and sets after his countryman, Chris Vermeulen. Stoner is absolutely flying in fourth place. Stoner behind the two Suzuki. So Sete Gibernau on the Ducati still leads the way. 20 and a half laps to go, and Gibbonau getting away at the front, and I think Stoner well aware of that. Up the inside of Chris Vermeulen. Stoner now tries to take over third place for Vermeulen and won't let him. Nicky Hayden trying to go up the inside of Stoner, also not able to do so. There is Casey Stoner. We have a man running wide. It's Colin Edwards, or it's Valentino Rossi in trouble. Valentino Rossi runs it wide. The saga continues for the world champion. Rossi now was in ninth place. He's surely lost that position. And here comes Loris Caparossi, Marco Melandri on the brakes. Marco Melandri has come from absolutely nowhere. Casey Stoner just blocks his path. It's all happening out there. Let's get it right. Gibbonau, Hopkins, Vermeulen, Stoner. It's across the line. Melandri, Hayden, Caparossi, Edwards, Pedrosa, Depunier, Nakano. We wait for Valentino Rossi. Rossi down in 14th place, would you believe? Valentino Rossi down in 14th place.
This is just confirming the trouble they've been having with the chatter, trying to get the thing to steer properly and get some confidence in the front end. Obviously, the choices they made this morning in the morning warm-up, they might have gone the wrong way, because that's the first time I've seen Rossi go backwards in a race in a long time.
And it's Nicky Hayden being pushed out wide there as well. So Nicky Hayden being pushed out wide at the turn, the complex coming into the start-finish area. He's down in sixth place. So Gibbonau leads the way. Hopkins in second place. Vermeulen having a great ride in third place. Still preventing Casey Stoner to get through there. What a performance by the Suzukis. Then we have Marco Melandri. Got Sete Gibbonau. Pole position last year. Third this year. Only his third ride on the Ducati. And these are the two Suzukis. After those disasters in Qatar, putting up a great performance. Stoner lining up Vermeulen once again. On the brakes, can Stoner get through? No, he can't.
Down in the second gear through there at about 100 kilometres an hour to get the good drive up through the back straight. They'll get up the fifth gear, 280 k's before they tip it in, settle the front at about 258 as they tip it through, and then accelerating through there up to 300, over 300 kilometres an hour. The front wheel fighting to stay on the deck. The guys on the pegs trying to hold the thing down as they come down on the brakes down to about 77 kilometres an hour.
Nicky Hayden fights back now, chasing after Marco Melandri. This is the battle for fifth place. There is Nicky Hayden chasing that seven successive podium finish. Tucked in behind him, the championship leader, Loris Caparossi, over the start and finish line. 19 laps to go. Gibbonau still leads the way. Hopkins second, Vermeulen still third. Stoner again trying to get up the inside of Chris Vermeulen. Not able to do so.
Rossi now past Tomata, Nick to move up the third, and Scott to give Nakano a bit of hurry, who's been relegated by Elias and DiPunio.
Yeah, Valentino Rossi still in 13th place. Problems for the world champion. Problems for the man making his 100th MotoGP appearance. No problems for these two fantastic Australians, Chris Vermeulen and Casey Stoner, fighting out for the moment for third place. It could be even higher. We ride with Casey Stoner. He really wants to get past Vermeulen. He's on the rumble strip. Now he's got the inside line on the brakes, and Casey Stoner takes over third place from Chris Vermeulen. Vermeulen fights back round the outside, but Stoner holds his line. Casey Stoner now up into third place. Chris Vermeulen relegated to fourth and coming under big, big pressure from Marco Melandri and Nicky Hayden.
Nick, I've got Paul Denning, the team manager of the Grizzler Suzuki team. Paul, what a marvellous start for you. This has been what you've been waiting for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, you know, our target's to finish the race and our target's to score some decent points, and the initial lap one and two pace of John in particular and Chris's surprised me. Let's just see if John can drag along with Sete and try and stay in the front group. I don't think it's going to be easy as the tyre performance drops off, but you know, the two riders are giving it everything
they can, so you've got to be happy with that.
All right, I'll come back and see you later.
No worries.
Now that's Paul Denning, and he's happy being a bit philosophical at the moment, not getting too excited like some of us.
Here comes Marco Melandri upside the inside of Chris Vermeulen. So Chris Vermeulen now down in fifth place. Marco Melandri didn't like the wet yesterday, but riding very, very well in the dry condition. And Nicky Hayden also coming through. So Hayden has also come through. Vermeulen now just dropping off the pace a little bit as they come over the start and finish line. Melandri in fourth place, Hayden fifth, Vermeulen sixth, Loris Caparossi seven, Edwards eighth, Pedrosa nine, Elias 10, Randy Depunier 11, Valentino Rossi still in 12th place. Loris Caparossi now really on the charge. It's his teammate that leads the way. And I think, Mark, I'm just checking the timing monitor, but I actually think that it's Loris Caparossi up in fourth place. Let's just check things out. No, in fact, I'm wrong as always. It's Marco Melandri coming under increasing pressure from Nicky Hayden, then Chris Vermeulen, then Loris Caparossi, but it's his teammate, Sadé Givenau, that leads the way. We ride with Danny Pedrosa. Pedrosa actually having a much better ride. He's in ninth place and chasing after Colin Edwards. Started from the back of the grid, 16th fastest for Danny Pedrosa. Didn't like the wet. But John Hopkins, you've got to say, is doing a brilliant job on the Suzuki, and he is not letting Sete Givenau get away. Of course, these two riders on Bridgestone tyres, and it's Casey Stoner in third place on the LCR Honda on Michelin's.
John Hopkins gave me a wink as I walked away from the grid there after talking to him, and he's very confident and just showing what they've done to this Suzuki. And when you're talking about Pedrosa, he's just got the fastest lap of the race too, Nick, so he's on the charge, although Edwards has got the fastest speed at 307 k's.
Yeah, 153.884 for Danny Pedrosa. We ride with Nicky Hayden. He's chasing very hard after Marco Melandri. There the two are. It's a break now for the left-hander. And Nicky Hayden has gone through. Nicky Hayden moves up into fourth place. Hayden chasing that seventh successive podium finish. He'd like to be even higher up, but he's now into fourth place. He's got Casey Stoner in his sights. Into the start and finish straight they come. 17 laps to go of this 22-lap Grand Prix of Turkey. Sete Givenau still leads the way. John Hopkins second. Casey Stoner third. Nicky Hayden now fourth. Marco Melandri fifth. Chris Vermeulen, Loris Caparossi, Colin Edwards, Danny Pedrosa with that fastest lap. In fact, the fastest lap of the race now has gone to Nicky Hayden, a 153.662 for Nicky Hayden. That's the fastest lap of the race. And Valentino Rossi now up into ninth place.
Well, just looking at the Michelin tyre charts there, Nick, Rossi's gone from medium front and a medium rear, whereas Hayden is on a soft front and a medium rear. Most of them are electing to go for the soft front, so we'll see how that can last, and all of them on the medium slicks at the rear.
Danny Pedrosa now getting in front of Colin Edwards, are moving up into eighth place. Well, Pedrosa didn't like the wet. It was his first real experience of MotoGP in the wet, but he is very, very fast indeed in the dry, as is Sete Givenau. At the front, John Hopkins hanging in there in second place, Casey Stoner third, Nicky Hayden, and then Marco Melandri, the man who won the race here last year.
And the woes continuing for the Danton Ducati team with Jose Luis Cardoso coming into the pits to retire.
Yeah, not had the best of starts, have they, to MotoGP. Just to remind you, Sete Givenau's last MotoGP victory was Qatar 2004, and the man that was there is down currently down in 11th place said he would never win a Grand Prix race again. Valentino Rossi. Stoner closing on John Hopkins. Hayden and Melandri pretty close. Vermeulen hanging in there well in sixth place. And then we have Loris Caparossi and Danny Pedrosa through the start and finish complex. The left that brings them back into the start and finish straight. Givenau crosses the line now. 16 laps to go. The gap about 3/10 of a second. Stoner getting closer and closer to Hopkins. Through the corkscrew, left and right, and then the long right-hander. Casey Stoner went home to Australia after the Qatar Grand Prix. Really has been a bit crook. Some antibiotics, some fishing, some time at home. Really has got him back to physical strength.
And Givenau, we can't forget the press conference yesterday, can we, Nick, where he's quick to point out that some people wrote him off, and he was very determined this weekend to basically shut their mouths, and he's doing the best job possible at the moment.
I tell you, he's doing a very good job as well, Danny Pedrosa. Danny Pedrosa has now moved up into seventh place in front of Loris Caparossi. He is absolutely flying.
And also, we can't forget Melandri, too. He was a bit of a struggle after and winning this race last year. He knows his way around here, and he knows he can do it, but certainly on the move at the moment.
10th place, Valentino Rossi. Colin Edwards, 9th. Pedrosa now up into 7th place as he's just overtaken Loris Caparossi. At the front, Givenau just opening up at a bit of an advantage. You get the feeling, certainly, that the Hondas of Hayden and certainly the Hondas of Melandri and certainly the Hondas of Stoner really want to try and get past Hopkins, because Givenau is getting away at the front. And Casey Stoner again has a little sniff up the inside of John Hopkins, but not able to do so. Now, if he's going to do it, this is may him do it. Fastest part of the circuit, breaking from 190 miles an hour down to first gear. Can Stoner do it? No, John Hopkins is really fierce on the brakes, and it's Nicky Hayden, in fact, that closes up on the rear wheel there of, Marco Melandri closing up on the rear wheel of Casey Stoner, and Nicky Hayden also. Oh, and Nicky Hayden's gone up the inside of Marco Melandri in the first part of the complex. They're coming to the start and finish straight. Hayden could have moved up. Let's wait and see as they go across the start and finish line. Chibanow and Stoner now up into second place. So Casey Stoner's done it. Stoner in second place. Hopkins relegated to third. Nicky Hayden fourth. Marco Melandri five. Danny Pedrosa absolutely flying. That fastest lap of the race. A 1:53.305. But I'm sure Chibanow will now be getting up the hurry up signs. Casey Stoner is after the man out the front, and Nicky Hayden has just moved into third place.
That move of Stoner started on the entrance to the chicane before the pit straight. He forced Hopkins wide, and look at Hayden and Hopkins now. But then while this is all going on, it's allowing Gibbonow to eke out a bit of a lead, and Stoner's making the most of it as well.
Yeah, Gibbonow's advantage over Stoner when they went over the start and finish line was just under 1 second. But I think, no disrespect, that John Hopkins was just slowing things up a little bit. Now the Hondas have got past him. They're going to set after the Ducati. And Hopkins loses two more places. Danny Pedrosa and Marco Melandri go past him. But Hopkins has done a good job at the front, but now dropping off the pace. Now, can Stoner, Hayden, Melandri, and you've got to say Pedrosa, start reeling in Chibanow at the front. That's the gap.
And another with the Suzukis, another thing with them is their power delivery. They've got a really peaky, narrow power band, which is very severe on their tyres as well, so maybe that's playing a part.
Danny Pedrosa after Marco Melandri. Pedrosa in sixth place, Melandri in fifth place. There are the two Suzukis together now, John Hopkins and Chris Vermeulen. Then a great job at the front, but you feel their race at the front is well over. On the brakes, Nicky Hayden trying to get up the inside of Casey Stoner. He came from absolutely nowhere. And Nicky Hayden now up into second place. Does he run it wide? Can Stoner get it back? He can. Casey Stoner says, I've ridden 250s. I know what to do here. And Casey Stoner tries to take him back. But Nicky Hayden does a Casey Stoner on the last lap and hangs in there as they come through the left-hander. And Nicky Hayden moves into second place.
And Stoner had to actually hesitate there so he didn't run up and hit Hayden as he tried to get past him again. You might have noticed that he sat up just in the middle of that corner.
So Chibanow at the front, that gap now down to 0.7 seconds. And it's Nicky Hayden now leading the chase. Stoner in third place, Marco Melandri four. Look out also for Danny Pedrosa, who is absolutely flying at the moment. Come from nowhere, the 250cc world champion. Spreads out a little bit behind them, but they are closing on Chibanow. The gap 0.7 seconds when they went through the start and finish line. They're up around this, a long, long left-hander that then comes up to turn seven. That's the right at the top end of the circuit. And Stoner now coming under real, real pressure from Nicky Hayden. Hayden up the inside, just hangs in there. Hayden hangs on to second place. Stoner fights back. Marco Melandri quite happy just to watch, and at the back of that lot is Danny Pedrosa, who is absolutely flying. What a race we've got. The Hondas in pursuit of the Ducati. Who's going to come out top with the Hondas? Can they catch the Ducati at the front? Hayden just about hangs in there from Casey Stoner, round the left and right. Chibanow's done a lot of hard work at the front. Now down for this very, very fast right-hander, fifth gear. Hayden's got Chibanow in his sight. Stoner still in third place. Melandri four. Pedrosa on the brakes coming up the inside of Marco Melandri. No way through. And Chris Vermeulen's done a really good job because he's at the back of that pack. And Chris Vermeulen is still in sixth place. Through the complex.
And see Hayden's corner speed through there, running right up on the back of Stoner there. Trying to get through. Sorry, it was Melandri. Pedrosa.
Chibanow still coming under pressure. Second place, Nicky Hayden. Third place now, Marco Melandri. Casey Stoner, fourth. Danny Pedrosa, five. Chris Vermeulen, six. Valentino Rossi still in 10th place. Major problems for the world champion.
And I've got Livio Sappo with me, Dan. Nick, the team manager of the Ducati Corse team. Livio, this is what Sede's been promising for quite a while.
He's doing a very good job, but now he's losing a little. Let's see what's happened, but it's a good race.
What was the tyre choice he went for?
A little bit different from Loris and Sete. They are both on front tire, medium and hard rear for Sete, opposite for Loris.
Oh, well, hopefully you can hang with it.
Thank you.
Olivia Sapo, the team manager from Ducati, been playing his cards close to his chest, but Sete Gibbenau is really taking the race by the horns and really trying to pull these guys away from him as he tries to break out a lead.
Well, Danny Pedrosa and Casey Stoner had a tremendous 250cc race last year. They're continuing that in MotoGP, but it's Pedrosa that's got in front of the Australian. Marco Melandri in front of Nicky Hayden. So Melandri won the race here last year in second place. Nicky Hayden third. Danny Pedrosa now fourth, and Casey Stoner in fifth place. But still, Sete Gibbenau leads the way. This is a tremendous performance by Melandri, who looked very, very unhappy in the wet qualifying yesterday. And here comes Pedrosa up the inside of Nicky Hayden and goes past him. Danny Pedrosa moves into third place. Pedrosa is absolutely flying. So Pedrosa now up into third place. Casey Stoner having to work very, very hard to hang in there with them at the moment. Long, long way to go when they cross the line. It's still 12 laps past my commentary position. And really now, Gibbenau under a big, big pressure. Less than one-tenth of a second, and Marco Melandri has taken the lead as they go into the corkscrew. Marco Melandri won his first ever MotoGP race here last year, takes the lead. Sete Gibbenau in second place. Danny Pedrosa third. Nicky Hayden four. Casey Stoner five. And Chris Vermeulen in sixth place. We then have Caparossi, Edwards, Rossi up into ninth. Elias Hopkins, Nakano, Depunier, Tamada, and Kenny Roberts Jr. completing the last of the point scorers in 15th place. Melandri really is on a charge at the front.
In the pit box for Nicky Hayden's pit board, he's had three different names on it in three laps. It's Stoner, Melandri and Pedrosa now laying on the ground, and they're waiting until the last moment before they put the next one in.
That's the sort of race it is. Marco Melandri leads the way. He won't forget that Grand Prix victory here last year when he rode quite brilliantly to beat Valentino Rossi and Nicky Hayden. Here is Nicky Hayden, currently lying in third place. Having to work very, very hard indeed to keep Nicky Hayden at bay. But Danny Pedrosa is absolutely flying. And Danny Pedrosa is so good on the brakes here, he could take the lead from Marco Melandri, not quite able to do so. Hayden has a back wheel out. Marco Melandri leads. Danny Pedrosa in second place. Pedrosa closing up all the time. Pedrosa, one would imagine, is going to take the lead any moment now. 11 and a half laps to go. Up over the rise. Sixth gear. Now down through the gearbox. Pedrosa's lining him up to take the lead. Pedrosa on the brakes. He crashed here in the wet yesterday. No such problems this time round. Danny Pedrosa runs it wide. And Marco Melandri hangs on to first place. Nicky Hayden also runs it a bit wide. And Casey Stoner is back in fourth.
Just the amazing turnaround now. They've got a dry track, like you said, Nick. Pedrosa struggling to qualify 16th. Melandri 14th. Now the pair of them leading the race.
This really is anybody's race. Anybody could win this one. Valentino Rossi has got in front of Tony Elias, and he's got in front of his teammate Colin Edwards, and he's now up into eighth place. Very important points for Valentino Rossi. If he remains in eighth place, he will be the highest point scorer ever in the history of Grand Prix motorcycle racing. At the front, they're not worried about these statistics. They're worried about who is going to win the race. Marco Melandri still leading the way from Danny Pedrosa.
John Hopkins in the pits to change a rear tyre.
Wow, poor old John Hopkins. Rode absolutely brilliant at the front, but now in the pits.
And you can see by the effect on the tyre, the way it is actually torn and it's slithered by the way the power comes onto the bike that has actually really shredded the tyre. So he's jumping on the bike now and about to head off, but you can see by his body language how disappointed he is.
John Hopkins running second for a long time in this race, but now in the pits to change that rear tyre. At the front, Marco Melandri and Danny Pedrosa, two former 250cc world champions, absolutely side by side. And I think it was Melandri that just held the advantage. And Chris Vermeulen is absolutely flying in sixth place, fighting off the challenge there of Loris Caparossi. Marco Melandri still hangs in there. Only just two MotoGP victories. One here last year. And here comes Danny Pedrosa again. It's that first part of the complex on the brakes. Pedrosa up the inside. He's going to take the lead this time. But can he hold it in there? He did it last time and then ran it a bit wide. This time he hasn't run it wide. Danny Pedrosa, I think, will lead the way as they come into the start and finish straight with 10 laps to go. What a performance by the 250cc world champion. is beating the former 250cc world champion as they cross the line. His great mentor, Alberto Poots, the former Grand Prix star, looks on. Must be very proud indeed. 125cc world champion, double 250cc world champion, and now he leads the Grand Prix of Turkey with 9 3/4 laps to go, and he is opening up a bit of an advantage. Nicky Hayden still in third place, fourth Casey Stoner, fifth Chris Vermeulen, sixth Sede Gibinau dropping off the pace, Loris Caparossi in seventh, Valentino Rossi eighth, Tony Elias nine, Colin Edwards 10, Nakano 11, Depunier 12, 13 Tamada, 14 Kenny Roberts, and 15th Alex Hoffman.
Nick, I've got Chris Herring with me because from press officer from Repsol Honda, as Alberto Poots doesn't like talking during the race. Chris really found something in the morning warm-up after what happened yesterday in the qualifying.
More on Friday, really, Mark. You know, it was going okay in the dry on Friday, and, you know, the rain just sort of spoiled things yesterday, and Danny, his confidence isn't so good in the rain. Thankfully, that hasn't affected today. You know, 16th to where he is now, he's quite incredible at the moment.
Yeah, it is, and especially to get through the field that he has got through.
Yeah, taking his time, you know, he's obviously thought about it. He's a very, very thoughtful rider, you know, brain like a computer, and there he is, you know. I just hope he can hold it together. You know.
And great for the young ones.
Yeah, I mean, they're all battling and sometimes tripping each other up, but, you know, at the moment, everything's going okay.
All right, best of luck.
Danny Pedrosa leads the way. Could he be securing his first ever MotoGP victory and only his third MotoGP appearance? His teammate Nicky Hayden says, I've got to do something about it. Gets up the inside of Marco Melandri and takes over second place. Casey Stoner is also in there, runs it wide. Oh, did they touch? Well, I don't know if they touched or not, but it didn't matter to Nicky Hayden because he's hung on to second place just into the start and finish straight. Repsol Honda fly the flag. They lead the way. They're 1 and 2. But what a race we've got for second place. Casey Stoner now trying to get up the inside of Marco Melandri. Not able to do so. But while this happens, Danny Pedrosa will keep going at the front, and Nicky Hayden knows that, and Nicky Hayden knows now he's got to set up after him as Pedrosa will break away at the front as he used to do in those 250cc races, and nobody will catch him.
It's interesting, Nick, these leading quartet have all got the same tyre combination, a soft at the front and a medium at the rear, so it's just a matter of who can conserve their tyres the most.
Wow. Certainly the way they're riding, nobody would imagine they're preserving their tyres too much, would they? Because this is another super race.
And James Ellison just came in to change a Dunlop, and it looks like Alex Hoffman is coming in and retiring as with the Danton Ducati as well.
So tyre problems for Bridgestone and Dunlop. We ride with Valentino Rossi, and Rossi now setting after Sete Givinau. So these two great rivals, more used to contesting races at the front. This time they're contesting seventh place, but it's a very, very important seventh place for the pair of them. Yamaha look on. Hasn't been the best of weekends for them so far. But he's going to get past Sede Gimeno up the inside, is he? Valentino Rossi. He's got Loris Caparossi in his sights. He could move up into sixth place any moment now. Rossi is absolutely flying. He's not going to win the race, but he's going to pick up some very valuable points. But at the front, Danny Pedrosa still leads the way from teammate Nicky Hayden. Marco Melandri still third, Casey Stoner four. And it does appear to me, the gap's about 0.8 seconds, that at the moment Hayden is making no impression on Pedrosa at the front.
It looks like Pedrosa ran it slightly wide there at that last section as they come onto the straight. We'll see what drive he can get, but he slowly gets it out there as they come past out.
8 laps to go. Danny Pedrosa's lead is 0.7 seconds over his teammate Nicky Hayden. We then have Melandri, Stoner, Vermeulen. This is Chris Vermeulen. Loris Caparossi coming under more and more pressure from Valentino Rossi. Behind Valentino Rossi, Tony Elias and Sete Gimeno dropping off the pace after leading in the early stages. Then we have Colin Edwards, Shinya Nakano 11, Randy Depunier 12, Tamada 13, Kenny Roberts 14, and Alex Hoffman, who I believe has just retired, so that probably moved Carlos Checa up into 15th place. Casey Stoner desperately trying to get past Marco Melandri, trying absolutely everything he knows, but at the moment, Melandri holding firm in third place. There's Chris Vermeulen, who is fifth, and Valentino Rossi has moved into sixth place now in front of Loris Caparossi, and he's now got Chris Vermeulen in his sights.
8 laps to go, Nick. Where can Valentino Rossi end up? He's just slowly been chipping away and getting closer to the front, but I don't know if he's going to catch this leading bunch.
Well, Pedrosa leads the way. We ride with Valentino Rossi in seventh place.
Well, it's interesting looking at the telemetry on board there, the difference where Melandri and Rossi are on the track.
Pedrosa, Hayden, Melandri and Stoner. Just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? Stoner still in fourth place, still trying to get past Marco Melandri through that very fast right hand up into sixth gear. Now they're going to break for the complex. Stoner not close enough. Hayden just closes a little bit on Danny Pedrosa, but he brings Melandri and Stoner along with him. I think this race has still got a long way to go, just over seven laps. You just get the feeling Hayden might bring these two along as well. Great day for Honda though. One, two, three, four. Chris Vermeulen in fifth place, but he in turn coming under real pressure from Valentino Rossi, who could put the Yamaha up any moment now into fifth place. There is Vermeulen, there is Rossi behind them. Loris Caparossi and Sete Givinau started with such confidence, they're just dropping back down through the field. But you can't speak highly enough about Chris Vermeulen. He may have qualified in the wet in pole position, but he has ridden quite brilliantly in the dry. But very interesting indeed that his teammate John Hopkins has come in and had to change a rear tyre. But Chris Vermeulen at the moment seemingly having no problems at all.
And Hayden taking 0.2 seconds out of Pedrosa during that lap. So is that Hayden closing it down, or has Pedrosa gone through his tyres too fast?
Only time will tell. Casey Stone is still after Marco Melandri. It's a tremendous performance though by Danny Pedrosa. A nasty crash yesterday, didn't enjoy the wet at all, but in the dry, as he showed both in Qatar and of course at that opening Grand Prix of the season in Jerez, just how good he is going to be in this MotoGP class. Second, of course, in Jerez, and the hopes of Spain rest very firmly on his shoulders. Nicky Hayden in second place, desperate to win his second Grand Prix. He won that first one in front of the home crowd at Laguna Seca. Marco Melandri, two Grand Prix victories, the first one here. And Casey Stoner, the winner of the 250cc race here last year. So wonderful mix, isn't it? Casey Stoner again thinks about trying to get the inside of Marco Melandri, but just not able to do so. But on the brakes this time, certainly Nicky Hayden really closes up on Danny Pedrosa. This is going to be a four-way battle to the finish. When they cross the line, there will be six laps to go of this magnificent Istanbul Park circuit. 3.318 miles. So just over 13 miles left. And this is going to be a race to the checkered flag. And Hayden certainly closing all the time. The gap now less than 0.2 seconds. Rossi and Vermeulen almost side by side, but Rossi now has moved up into fifth place. One would imagine that will have to be it for Valentino Rossi. But a superb ride by the world champion, picking up world championship points. Now it's all happening at the front.
This is going to be one sensational finish of the race, similar to the 250. Well, not, hopefully not as dramatic, but Hayden has taken nearly half a second out in the last couple of laps. So, and he's dragged the other two with him. Melandri and Stoner are no way out of this race at the moment.
They certainly are not. 5.5 to go. Pedrosa, here comes Melandri up the inside of Hayden. Whoa, I think he caught him a little bit by surprise. The fastest lap of the race also for Marco Melandri. So the fastest lap of the race at 1:53.261 for Marco Melandri. He caught me by surprise. I think he caught Nicky Hayden by surprise. And Marco Melandri wants to repeat his victory of last season. Casey Stoner just sits it out in fourth place, looking very comfortable, very composed. His moment will come before the end. We're absolutely sure of that. And here comes Stoner as we speak. Stoner has pushed Hayden back to fourth place and now moves into third. So Hayden, who was absolutely flying, closed right up, did all the donkey work to catch up Danny Pedrosa at the front. He was second, now he's fourth, and having to work very hard to stay in there.
Well, he's just been mugged twice in about three corners by the youngsters, so here comes Melandri as well.
Melandri on the brakes, goes past Danny Pedrosa. Marco Melandri leads the way. Stoner closes on Pedrosa, but Marco Melandri leads the race for the first time. Now Stoner sets himself up for the complex. Has he set himself up for the left-hander? No, I don't think he's quite close enough. No. So Danny Pedrosa will hang on to second place. You're absolutely right, Mark. This could go absolutely anywhere. Oh, Danny Pedrosa gets the front wheel of the Honda in the air. Casey Stoner says, OK, you keep the front wheel in the air and I will move into second place. Stoner now up into second place. We could be looking at that Freddie Spencer record even yet.
Well, they're exactly the same age, days and years, so it's amazing what could happen. Luke, the team there of Stoner looking at the monitors. I thought Stoner was going to have a good look then.
So Casey Stoner in second place. Marco Melandri leads the way. Third now is Danny Pedrosa, who did a lot of the hard work at the front. And Nicky Hayden, who also has done his share of all the hard work, now in fourth place and having to work very, very hard to stay with these youngsters at the front. Stoner thinks about singing up the inside of Marco Melandri. You've got to say, Mark, Casey Stoner looks very composed there in second place at the moment.
Yeah, well, we've seen in the previous races, the guys that usually hang behind and just watch what's going in front tend to save their tyres and see what else, where the other guys are a bit weak or where their strengths are. So this could be a repeat performance in the MotoGP class.
Look at that, Valentino Rossi now up into fifth place. I think that is it for Valentino Rossi. He's not going to catch these at the front. Stoner now alongside Marco Melandri on the brakes. Can Stoner take the lead? Not quite. Danny Pedrosa back in the hunt. Nicky Hayden back in the hunt. Just look at Valentino Rossi. He is absolutely flying. Goes past Tony Elias, up into fifth place. He'd love to be involved in this particular battle, and he'd be right in the middle of it, but he's not in the middle of it. The new names of MotoGP there, and Casey Stoner is going to take the lead, is he? Casey Stoner on the brakes has moved up the inside of Marco Melandri. Stoner leads the way. The 20-year-old Australian leads the Grand Prix once again. Stoner leads. Pedrosa in third place, Nicky Hayden fourth, Marco Melandri relegated to second, into the start and finish straight. Four laps to go. Casey Stoner leads the Grand Prix of Turkey.
Well, I think, Nick, that Casey Stoner learned a lot in Qatar. In Qatar, he went from the start and tried to break their back. This lap, this race, he's just settled in, watch what everybody else is doing and making his move when it counts at the end of the race.
Casey Stoner. 3.5 laps to go. The Australian, and only his third appearance in MotoGP, leads the Grand Prix of Turkey. He won the 250cc race here last year. Can he win a MotoGP race at the same circuit? Stoner, Melandri, Pedrosa, Hayden, Rossi fifth, Elias sixth, Vermeulen going well in seventh, eighth Caparossi, the championship leader, ninth Edwards, 10th Nakano, 11th Givinau, 12 Tamada, 13 Depunier, 14 Kenny Roberts, and Alex Hoffman in 15th place.
Nick, I'll just have a quick word with Lucio Ciccanello, Casey Stoner's team manager. He's running this race to perfection, Lucio.
Yes, he's doing very well at the moment. Of course, I cannot say anything about at this moment because, of course, it's three laps to the end and first position, so...
But he learned a lot at Qatar. He led early there and went backwards, but this race, he has waited till the right moment.
Yeah, I think that he did a really, really great job with the team and improved a lot. Also, all the technical stuff find a very good setup in his bike, so we are very, very happy.
Okay, thanks, Lucio.
You're a brave man talking to Lucio, because I suspect there's a lot of prayers going on down there on pit wall. Casey Stoner leads the way, followed by Marco Melandri, Danny Pedrosa and Nicky Hayden. Into the start and finish straight, three laps to go. What is the gap? The gap is 0.6 seconds. Stoner brake and throttle on the brakes. We're comparing with Pedrosa. Obviously on the throttle just a little bit early because he leads the way. Marco Melandri now down in fourth place. Nicky Hayden has got past him. Danny Pedrosa still in second place. Nicky Hayden knows that he's got to have a go any moment now. It's going to be too late. Here we go. Nicky Hayden up the inside of Marco Melandri, then onto the brakes. The Turkish corkscrew, as we call it.
Melandri didn't get the drive out of that final corner that Hayden did, and it was that's why he swept past him so easily.
Casey Stoner now coming under a little bit of pressure. Little bit of pressure, but he's used to pressure. He won the 250cc race here last year. 2.5 laps to go for the Australian, the 20-year-old. Danny Pedrosa still in second place. Marco Melandri third.
Pedrosa and Stoner had a great rivalry in the 250s. We could be seeing the continuation of this in MotoGP at what could be the start of a long and rivalry over the next few years.
Nicky Hayden dropping off the pace. Nicky Hayden's dropping out of this particular battle. It was four, now it's three. Problems for Nicky Hayden. No problems for the men at the front. Casey Stoner through the chicane, still leads the way. Danny Pedrosa second, Marco Melandri third. But Nicky Hayden obviously has had problems through the very, very fast right-hander. This is where Casey Stoner crashed yesterday. This is where Marco Melandri has not crashed, but it's where Danny Pedrosa crashed yesterday. Marco Melandri moves into second place. Melandri pushes Pedrosa back to third. When they come through the complex, past our commentary box window, there will be two laps to go for Casey Stoner and Australia. Can he do it? Can he win the MotoGP Grand Prix here in Turkey? It's going to be very, very close indeed. We ride with Danny Pedrosa. That's Marco Melandri in front of him. Just got a glimpse there of Nicky Hayden in fourth place. Valentino Rossi still fifth. Tony Elias across the line in sixth place. Well, I think this could go any way of three. I don't think that's a particularly brave man making that assumption. Any one of these three could win this race. But it's Casey Stoner who still leads the way. He started the last MotoGP race in pole position. He eventually finished fifth. Lucio Ceccanello, the man that really has put Casey Stoner where he is, nearly top of the MotoGP tree. He's so, so proud of him. Two very, very different characters, but they really have gelled. Stoner still leads. Marco Melandri, desperate to repeat his Grand Prix victory of last season. And Danny Pedrosa, like Casey Stoner, chasing his first ever MotoGP victory, the current 250cc world champion. Him and Stoner had a rare old battle in the 250cc class here last year, last October. But is Pedrosa close enough to mount a challenge to Stoner? We wait and see. Down the hill, into the left and right. This is turn nine. You've got to get really good drive out of this, because then you've got this very fast 160 mile an hour right-hander coming up now. Melandri took it in sixth gear by mistake last year and almost crashed. They take it flat out in fifth, momentarily up into sixth now, down through the gearbox and brake for the complex. And you've got to say, I don't think Melandri is close enough to get through to Stoner this time round. Pedrosa trying to go around the outside. He will have the advantage though when they flick it right, but Pedrosa not able to get through. That will help Stoner.
No, he went the long way around there, Nick. That was the move destined, not the work, because Melandri had the line and got the drive out, and that's put Pedrosa right back at the moment.
One lap to go. 5.340 kilometres. 3.318 miles for Casey Stoner. Can he win his first ever MotoGP Grand Prix? And down goes Danny Pedrosa. Pedrosa has gone down from second place. Marco Melandri, sorry, from third place. Marco Melandri in second place. That one moved Nicky Hayden up. Now, this is a straight fight between Marco Melandri and Casey Stoner. Danny Pedrosa has stepped out. He looks okay, but Danny Pedrosa out of the race. Three quarters of a lap to go. Melandri's starting to mount the pressure on Stoner at the front.
Stoner ran it wide there to get good drive through the last part of that left-hander. We'll see if he can. And look at Melandri coming through now.
Marco Melandri closing on the Australian. Melandri chasing Grand Prix victory number three in the MotoGP class. Casey Stoner chasing Grand Prix victory number one. Melandri, without a shadow of a doubt, will have a go. Will Stoner be able to rebuff him? Will Stoner perhaps be able to retake the lead? We wait to see. Half a lap to go here at the Grand Prix of Turku. This magnificent Istanbul Park circuit. Casey Stoner, less than half a lap now for the 20-year-old Australian. Through the chicane. Now the fearsome fast right-hander coming up. Stoner wants to be a good bit in front of Melandri though when they break for the complex. The left, right and left that brings them back in the start and finish straight. This is where the race will be decided, ladies and gentlemen. Down the straight they come, on the brakes. Melandri trying to get up the inside. Is he going to get through? Marco Melandri tries to go through. Stoner holds the advantage. They go left, now they go right. Melandri is taking the advantage. Marco Melandri leads the way. Just the left-hander now for Marco Melandri. Can Stoner fight back? Marco Melandri could make it Grand Prix victory number three. Marco Melandri is going to win the Grand Prix of Turkey here in Istanbul. Casey Stoner, what a ride into second place. Nicky Hayden in third place, and what a performance by Valentino Rossi fourth, and Tony Elias fifth. Marco Melandri is back in business.
Well, I might know Marco Melandri's team, Nick, but I've got Lucio Ceccanello. Lucio, congratulations, your first podium with Casey in the MotoGP.
Yeah, of course. We have all everybody very, very happy. A little bit disappointed for the last corner, but this doesn't mean that Casey didn't do a super wonderful job, and this is fantastic for Casey, for the team, and for everybody who working very hard for go ahead with this project.
Good on you, and go and see him in down in Park Fermo.
Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Danny Pedrosa coming across the line now in 14th place. He could have won the race, couldn't he, Danny Pedrosa? But down he went in turn one.
Yeah, Nick, I saw that before the previous lap through the one of the left-handers at the back. You could see his front tucking a bit as he was sliding through the track. So he was really on the limits of adhesion with his front tyre, with the soft tyre using too much of it. And as we saw going through that off-camber first corner, it was all too much for it.
Danny Pedrosa down but not out, eventually finishing the race in 14th place. But what a victory for Marco Melandri. There's Tony Elias just giving the thumbs up to Casey Stoner. Great ride by Casey Stoner. I think Lucio Ceccadello will probably echo the way Casey Stoner feels. They're winners. That was a fantastic ride by Casey Stoner. But I think they felt, we felt, I'm sure Casey Stoner felt, he might have won that race. There he is, shaking hands with Valentino Rossi. What a performance by Rossi from absolutely nowhere. Nearly caught Nicky Hayden at the finish, didn't he? And finishes in fourth place. We've had an absolutely, truly amazing day's racing here in Turkey. 125, 250, and a fabulous, fabulous MotoGP race. And Nicky Hayden on the podium for the seventh successive time. But knowing Nicky Hayden as well, I don't think he'll be too happy. Though my quick mathematics tell me that Nicky Hayden should now be leading the World Championship. So Nicky Hayden may be disappointed at not winning the race, but for the first time, Nicky Hayden will be leading the MotoGP World Championship. But the man back in form is Marco Melandri. Melandri making his way back with the Italian flag proudly on his back. The 23-year-old, of course, the former 250cc world champion, finished runner-up last year in the MotoGP World Championship. Won those last two Grand Prix here in Turkey and in Valencia. But now really back to his best. It's absolutely blown the championship wide open. It is going to be a superb World Championship this year. Three separate winners. Loris Caparossi, Valentino Rossi, and now Marco Melandri. I thought the only thing about them is it's three Italians. Nicky Hayden leads the World Championship. I think you can see from his crew chief, Pete Benson, as well. A few problems for Nicky Hayden. Just at the end of the race, he just dropped off the pace a bit. But he hung in there, didn't he? And when Danny Pedrosa went down, Nicky Hayden very, very happy indeed to take over a podium finish. Valentino Rossi, fine ride by the world champion into fourth place. He is now the highest point scorer in the history of Grand Prix motorcycle racing.
Just down here in Parc Fermé, Nick, and Fausto Grassini, the manager of the Marco Melandri, is wiping the sweat away. He's still shaking, I think, after that dramatic race. And we've got to take our hats off to the layout of this Turkish circuit. This really goes well for racing.
Certainly does, doesn't it? Danny Pedrosa back in his pit box. He'll be disappointed. But he showed he can run with those front runners, can't he? He really can run with it. Here we are, just going to lose the front end. Tucks under. Turn one on the last lap. All that work throughout the weekend. All that tremendous ride in the race. Third place was there. But he's frayed back in his pit box. But typically ran back to pick up the bike and still finished 14th fastest. Here comes the man in question into pit lane. Marco Melandri wins his third Grand Prix of his MotoGP career, his first race win of the season. And you've got to say, that was one hell of a race. I think he's letting his engine do the talking. There is Fausto Grassini.
And just as all this is happening, John Hopkins is pushing his bike back, so that's just made it to the finish.
John Hopkins eventually finishing 17th fastest. Good ride by Christopher Mullen in the seventh place. Qualified in pole, of course, in the wet. Really hung in there in the dry. This is a very strong company there behind Loris Caparossi in front of Shinya Nakano. I'd say that's a fabulous performance. But the day belongs to Marco Melandri. The day belongs to his Grassini Honda team. And who knows now what is going to happen in the World Championship with Nicky Hayden taking over the lead from Loris Caparossi. I think everybody's pretty pleased about that particular victory.
Well, he's been struggling at the beginning of the year, but came back and he probably now would go into his favourite circuit of all time. Two wins and one in the 250s and now in the MotoGP class.
Casey Stoner, what an attempt by Casey Stoner to win that race. Eventually finishing in second place, his first podium finish in MotoGP, and the boy is absolutely flying. Nicky Hayden, third for Nicky. Problems at the end of the race, but when Danny Pedrosa went down, he was happy to take his seventh successive podium finish. But very important indeed, the fact that he has taken over the lead in the World Championship. And the last American to do that, one would imagine, would have been Kenny Roberts Jr., the year he won the 500cc title back in 2000. Martin Raines is probably sitting at home in Hull. He's probably going to prove me wrong the time we reach China. Great scenes here at Istanbul Park. And there we are, confirmation of the result. 200th of 1 second between Marco Melandri and Casey Stoner. Nicky Hayden third. A fantastic ride by Valentino Rossi into fourth place. Tony Elias fifth. That was a good ride by him also. Loris Caparossi, a disappointing sixth. Chris Vermeulen, excellent seventh. Good solid ride by Shinya Nakano into eighth place. Colin Edwards, 9. Makoto Tomada, 10. Sete Gimeno led the way for so long, 11. Randy Depunier, 12. Kenny Roberts Jr., 13. Danny Pedrosa, despite that crash on the last lap, 14. Carlos Checa picking up a lone point in 15th place. Sadly, poor old John Hopkins put on a fabulous show early in the race. Really pushed hard in second place. Rear tyre problems. And I'm afraid then he dropped out of the reckoning and out of the points. There we go. Wow. Nicky Hayden leads the World Championship for the very first time by one single point from Loris Caparossi. Marco Melandri third, a further 7 points adrift. Casey Stoner fourth in the MotoGP World Championship.
Congratulations. What a hard-fought race. You said to me yesterday you didn't expect to see this for a while, and you certainly got there quick.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, I almost had this race, and, you know, unfortunately it didn't work out that way, but still a dream come true to be on the podium of a MotoGP race, and only my third race yet, so we're slowly moving up there, and you know, hopefully in the races ahead we can keep improving. If not, then you know, I'm just going to have to work harder.
How much did Qatar teach you from leading early to sit back and just watch what everybody else was doing?
Qatar, I was just sick. I had no energy the whole race, so I was just pretty much hanging in there the whole way. This race, I was there, I was focused. You know, I was there 100% through the race, and I could pretty much just plan it from there.
And the end of the back straight, you must have been at the limit of your tyres trying to hang on for the last lap?
Pretty much. I was just come on there pretty hard and hooking it, leaning over a fair bit. And then I was just basically trying not to let the back rear break away coming into that hairpin. And unfortunately, Melandri is a little bit better under brakes there, and that's the way it goes.
Well, you know you can do it now, can't you?
Yeah, it's a big confidence boost for me now, and you know, I thought I can do all these practices and everything easy. And in the Thursday press conference, Valentino said I just need to learn how to ride on old tyres. And I corrected him, you know, the fact that I was sick in Qatar. And, you know, today I think I was probably the most confident on the old tyres today.
Enjoy it, mate. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Casey Stoner. We now watch the highlights of another great MotoGP race. It was Sete Gimeno that led the way. Casey Stoner up into second place, coming under real pressure, though, from Nicky Hayden. Marco Melandri also there, making a tremendous start from very near the back row of the grid. But Gimeno really flying at the front, but the pack after him, and after him in big style. Marco Melandri moving up into third place in front of Casey Stoner. Spreading out all over the place. Marco Melandri takes the lead for the first time as they go into turn one. Chris Vermeulen really hanging in there well on the Suzuki after starting from pole position. Melandri then coming under pressure from Nicky Hayden, and then Danny Pedrosa. Danny Pedrosa takes the lead, 250cc world champion. Rossi absolutely carving his way through the field after the problems he had earlier. But at the front, Danny Pedrosa leads the way. Casey Stoner moves into third place. Nicky Hayden relegated to fourth. And then Marco Melandri takes the lead. Casey Stoner then back in front. What a fabulous end of the race that this is going to be. Melandri leads from Stoner. Stoner then dives up the inside. Casey Stoner now leads the way, chasing his first MotoGP victory. Pedrosa and Hayden looking threatening. Danny Pedrosa goes down, turn one on the last lap. There were four, now there are three, but Nicky Hayden's off the pace. A straight fight between Stoner and Malandri. Stoner tries all he knows, but Malandri just holds the advantage into that start and finish complex. Danny Pedrosa rides back onto the track, but Marco Malandri wins the Grand Prix of Turkey. Casey Stoner secures his first ever MotoGP podium. Nicky Hayden third, and Valentino Rossi in fourth place.
Have you seen three better races in a long time, Nick?
I certainly haven't. Congratulations to Marco Malandri, the winner here in Turkey, and the World Championship wide open. Nicky Hayden leading the way. Well, it's Grand Prix Racing's only second appearance on two wheels in Turkey. How the crowd have enjoyed it. And I hope back at home throughout the world you've enjoyed it. It really doesn't get a lot better than what we've seen today. The podium awaits the arrival of Marco Malandri, Casey Stoner and Nicky Hayden.
I think if the riders have got anything to do with it, Nick, we'll be coming to Turkey for many years to come.
Well, three as good races as you'd really want to see. Alvaro Bautista not winning the 125. That was a big shock. A dramatic 250cc race. An end that you'd never wish to... You could never guess what happens at the end. I'm not telling you what happened. And then a fabulous MotoGP race with Marco Malandri just pipping Casey Stoner at the finish to win. And Nicky Hayden, who's now coming onto the podium in third place. But Nicky Hayden leads the World Championship for the first time. Casey Stoner arrives. Marco Malandri arrives with the obligatory shades. Nick Hayden shakes his hand. But Marco Malandri is back. There's no doubt about that. Fausto Grassini, the man behind Marco Malandri's success behind him. Of course, a former world champion himself. Sam Lyon issuing the instructions, getting the riders out there on time and in the right positions. Nicky Hayden in third place. Casey Stoner for the first time on a MotoGP podium. But the afternoon belongs to Marco Malandri. So the final presentation of a marvellous afternoon of Grand Prix motorcycle racing is for MotoGP. And in third place, Nicky Hayden, the new leader in the World Championship. Mehmet Atalay, the minister in charge of youth sports. Certainly there's some youthful faces up on that podium at the moment. Hayden looks a little bit disappointed, but you do feel that Nicky Hayden will not be too disappointed when he looks at that World Championship chart position. Casey Stoner in second place, his first ever podium finish in the MotoGP class. He so nearly won the race. He is going to win a MotoGP race before the end of this season. I think we're all absolutely sure about that.
I'll put my money on China. He won there last year, Nick.
And the man of the moment, back in top form after a disappointing start to the season, is the former 250cc world champion. He was runner-up in the MotoGP World Championship last year. He secured his first ever victory here in Turkey. He's repeated the toast. It's Marco Malandri. Well, it really has blown the World Championship wide open, hasn't it? Malandri now right back in form. I think we knew he was going to be a championship contender this year after his fine displays last year. And it's just been a little slow coming, but now he's on full charge. And it's his team manager, the man behind the team, the former Grand Prix winner and world champion himself, Fausto Grassini.
Thank you.
There, Fausto Grassini winning the team prize. So, no Spanish national anthem this time round. It's the Italian national anthem for Marco Melandri. Marco Melandri is back, ladies and gentlemen. Casey Stone is surely going to win that first Grand Prix in the MotoGP class before long. And Nicky Hayden leads the World Championship for the very first time. What a day we've had in Turkey. Let the champagne flow. They don't want to bring it for Marco Melandri. I'm sure he's not going to spread over the girls that bring it. I'm sure he wouldn't do that.
No, he'd never do that, would he, Nick?
No. Here we come. Loud music, pretty girls, and a MotoGP day, a 125 day, and a 250cc day. Never to be forgotten here in Istanbul.